Welcome to Strength of Materials video class. In this video, we will be having the two derivations and two numericals. Analysis of uniformly tapering circular rod is the first derivation. A bar of uniformly tapering from a diameter 1, D1 at one end to a diameter D2 at the other end as shown in the figure. So this figure is going to have the values as diameter 1 and diameter 2. We are able to see the D1 as the diameter 1, D2 as the diameter 2. And length of the tapering circular rod is capital L. Whereas we are considering the elemental particular diameter as dx and its length as small dx, which is at a distance of x from the left end, and the whole section is having the tension force acting capital P on both the end. Now similarly, consider a small element of a length L dx of the bar at a distance x from the left end. Let the diameter of the bar be dx at a distance of x from the left end. Dx is d1 minus this particular diameter value we need to determine, that is, so d1 minus in bracket d1 minus d2 by L into x, substituting that in terms of k. So the d1 minus d2 divided by L is substituted in terms of k. So dx will be equal to d1 minus k into x. The area of cross section of the bar at a distance x from the left end we are going to calculate. So area is known to us for a diameter section. Ax is equals to pi by 4 into dx square. So dx value is already known to us, that is d1 minus kx. We will substitute in the equation of area. So we get it as pi by 4 into bracket d1 minus kx, bracket closed, so whole bracket is in square. So Ax, area of cross sectional at dx at a distance of x, will be pi by 4 into bracket d1 minus kx square. Then now stress at a distance x from the left end is given by sigma x is equals to load divided by area, which is equals to P divided by pi by 4 into bracket d1 minus kx whole square is equals to 4p. 4 is the denominator of denominator, which is coming as numerator. So 4p divided by pi into d1 minus k bracket closed square. Now the strain is Ex in the small element of length dx is obtained by using equation capital E is equals to sigma divided by E is the strain. So the strain, we are able to resubstitute or rearrange the things in terms of Ex is equals to sigma x divided by capital E is equals to 4p divided by pi into bracket d1 minus kx square into 1 upon E. So rearranging these things, 4p divided by pi into E into bracket d1 minus kx whole square. Therefore, extension of the small elemental length dx is equals to strain multiplied by dx, strain multiplied by the length of the small element. So writing this in terms of will be equal to 4p divided by pi e into bracket d1 minus kx square multiplied by the elemental length dx. Now, the total extension of the bar is obtained by integrating the above equation between the limits 0 and L. So, considering this, therefore, total extension is equals to dl is equals to integration which limits from 0 to L in this 4p divided by pi e into bracket d1 minus kx bracket square dx is equals to 4p divided by pi e integration of 0 to L is the limits, then here 1 divided by d1 minus kx bracket close square dx equals to 4p by pi e integration of 0 to x, this rearranging in terms of into bracket d1 minus kx bracket closed raised to minus 2 dx. We are going to integrate this thing now. So, integrating, before we will do this, multiplying and dividing it by minus k. So, when we do the same thing, minus k is multiplied and divided for the equations, we are able to have and integrating it dl 4p by pi e into bracket d1 minus kx raised to minus 1 divided by minus 1 into minus k in the upper limit and lower limit. So, lower limit is 0, upper limit is L. So, substituting that in the things and again simplifying this part as raised to minus 1 and this k gets multiplied and becomes as a positive things. So, minus 1 into minus k, it is positive k, k comes outside. So, 4p by pi e k and this raised to 1 will be coming as 1 divided by d1 minus k x. And now substituting the upper limit and lower limit values, we can find out 4p by pi e k into bracket 1 divided by d1 minus k l minus 1 divided by d1 minus k 0. So, 0 value will be 0. So, remaining part is only 4p by pi e k into bracket 1 divided by d1 minus k l minus d1. Now, let us substitute the value of k into the particular formula. So, substituting the value of k, as earlier we have the value of k as k is equals to d1 minus d2 we have considered. This part we will be substituting into the equation and we find this part of equation, that is 4p divided by pi e into d1 minus d2 divided by l. Now this del is in the denominator of denominator, will become as the numerator in the next step. And here again l gets cancelled, the remaining thing is 1 divided by d1 minus into bracket d1 minus d2 minus 1 divided by d1. If we take out this into the bracket, then the particular thing will be in terms of this 4pl divided by pi e into d1 minus d2 into bracket 1 minus d1 minus of d1 plus d2 minus 1 divided by d1. Now this d1 minus and d1 plus will get cancelled. So, remaining is 1 divided by d2 minus 1 divided by d1. So, dl is equals to 4pl divided by pi e d1 minus of d2 divided by into bracket 1 divided by d2 minus d1 is there in the equation. Now, cross multiplying the things d1 and d2 in this particular part and checking what happens if we go for further simplification. dl is equals to 4pl divided by pi e d1 minus d2 into d1 minus d2 after finding the cross multiplication and doing LCM d1 by d2. So After we this find, we are able to cancel d1 minus d2, d1 minus d2. So remaining part is 4pl by pi e d1 d2. So the total extension can be seen for the particular analysis of circular rod with varying sections as, therefore, total extension dl is equals to 4pl divided by pi e d1 d2. This is the equation. The second equation of this video. Analyze if the rod is uniform diameter. Before going to that, I will be taking the diameter as same. D1 is equals to D2 and D2 is equals to common as D. What will be the equation? So the equation turns out into total extension DL is equals to 4PL divided by pi e D square will be the equation. Now going to second derivation, that is analysis of uniformly tapering rectangular bar. Rectangular bar wherein the section is given. A bar of a constant thickness. Constant thickness, we will consider the thickness as 1. We will consider the thickness as 1. And uniformly tapering means one end is larger dimension, another end is smaller dimension. In width from one end to another end as shown in the figure. So we can see this part of the end. So this part of the end is with the A marking, which is the greatest dimension, and a B marking, which is the smallest dimension of the particular member, and the element we are going to consider it at XX. So elemental width, let us consider, or length, let us consider it as dx, which is situated at a x distance from the A end, means the larger end, and total length is again a capital L itself only, what we have already taken for the previous section. Similar type of section is also there, but there it was the circular, here it is the rectangular, this is the capital L. So let P be the axial load on the bar, L length of the bar, A width at the bigger end, B width at smaller end, E Young's modulus, and T thickness of bar. We are considering the thickness of the bar as 1 for the our reference. Let us take the thickness of bar as 1. Okay. Now consider any section XX at a distance of X from the bigger end. From here we are considering X distance and XX section we are going to consider at the bigger end. So this is XX section at a X distance from bigger end. Width of the bar at a section XX is, we will consider what is the width of the bar. So width of the bar is nothing but this particular section. We are going to see it into the particular formulation, what part of width we will be able to see this section, which is equals to a minus b into x divided by l, which is a minus k into x. So same as previous d1 minus k into x, it is now a minus k into x, where k is equals to a minus b by l. There it was d1 minus d2 by l, similar to that. Thickness of a bar at a section xx is equals to t, and therefore area of a section at xx is equals to width into thickness. So now width is a minus k into x into t will be the area of the section at xx. Therefore stress at the section xx can be determined by sigma x is equals to load upon area. So load is p, area will be into bracket a minus k into x into thickness small t. extension of a small elemental length dx is equals to strain into length of dx, that is the smallest length. So therefore, stress, if we again rearrange, we will be able to get this as the strain. So this particular strain, if we consider and write it, this particular part of formula will be, this is the strain, we are able to see that stress divided by Young's modulus into dx, which is, we are writing stress as P by area into E into x, that is the dx what we are going to consider. Total extension of the bar is obtained by the integrating the above equation between the limits 0 and L. So substituting that for the total extension, so this is the part of dx. Here dx will be coming, that which I have written it as x. Now when we substitute for the integration, P by E into bracket E minus kx into t dx. So P and ET, P divided by ET, we are taking it outside and finding out the integration of only this term dx divided by 1a minus kx. So integrating that term, we will be able to see that P by ET is equals to log E into bracket a minus kx limit 0 to 1 multiplied by minus 1 by k. So again, taking into that minus 1 by k as the external part, P divided by minus P divided by E into T into K log of E base 2 A minus K into L minus of log E minus A. Substituting those values and again simplifying, we get it as plus 2 more positive and negative this in term. So changing the term as positive to negative, negative to positive, we will be taking this in term of positive and this in term of negative. So that we have rearranged, P divided by E into TK log base 2 EA minus log base 2 into bracket A minus K into L. So again, checking out this log base 2 E log base 2 E log of M minus log of N is log of M divided by N. We know that this part, that is log of M divided by N, we are going to write it in terms of log of M minus log of N. So again, it will be a reverse in form, log of M minus N is log of N minus M divided by N. We are writing in this particular format. Now further part, if we take substitution of K value into the particular equation and substituting it and simplifying, we are able to see that the particular substitution and further part, we will be able to have the total extension of the bar of rectangular size with uniform thickness as T. Delta L is equals to PL divided by ET into bracket A minus B log base 2 E A divided by B will be the value. So this part of value, we are able to get it easily. So now two problems, numericals on the particular extension part. So the numerical is a rod which tapers uniformly from 240 mm diameter to 20 mm diameter in the length of 400 mm is subjected to an axial load of 5000 newtons if E is equals to 2.1 e to 10 to the 5 newton per mm square. Find the extension of the rod. Extension is required means the delta L is required. So that we need to determine. So the simple thing, larger dia D1 as 40, smaller dia D2 as 20 mm. Length of the rod L as 400 mm. Axial load P as 5000 newtons. Young's modulus E is equals to 2.1 into 10 to the 5 newton per mm square. Let DL is equals to total extension of the rod. So DL, we will consider it as total extension of the rod. We have delta L is equals to 4PL divided by pi E D1 D2 as the formula which we have derived. Substituting the values into the formula, we can find the total extension of the rod. And once we substitute the values, we are able to easily calculate the extension as 0.01515 mm. The numerical completes. Similarly, same another numerical wherein find the modulus of elasticity of for a rod. Here we need to determine what is Young's modulus, which tapers uniformly from 30 mm to 15 mm diameter in a length of 350 mm. The rod is subjected to an axial load of 5.5 kN and extension of the rod is to 0.25 mm. Now when we take it for the thing, so the solution is length of a rod L is equals to 350 mm, axial load P is equals to 5.5 kN, 5500 newtons. Extension of the rod is already given, delta L is equals to 0.025 as the extension as the 0.025. here was the small correction, you make this correction as 0.025 mm. Now taking the equation as delta L is equals to 4PL divided by pi E D1 D2. Substituting the values which are known to us, D1 is 30 mm and D2 is 15 mm and length is 350 mm. Substituting that part and P as 5500 newtons, we get the value of Young's modulus capital E as 2178.65 newton per mm square or 2.17865 × 10⁵ newton per mm square as the Young's modulus of the numerical. So this video was related to two derivations and the numericals related to the circular rod. Next video will be related to numerical of rectangular rod and further part of strength of materials on simple stress and strain part. Thank you and see you in the next video.